Okay, so we've made it to module 18. Can you believe it? This is the last module in our series, Excel 2010. And I wanted to take some time and just talk to you a little bit about some of the additional features that Excel has that will make life a lot easier as you're working. So let's start off in this first section talking about the comments feature. Basically, what comments are notes that you're going to be able to insert. So if you shared this file with someone, that would be very helpful because you could make notes about the data in a particular cell. It would also be helpful to yourself if you decided to open this file 6 months later and you weren't sure what that data represented, you would have some notes to go back and look at. So let's take a minute and go look at that. Now first, let's see how they've set up this exercise. This is our company, Benjamin of Brussels, International Chocolate Distributors. And it looks like they're tracking each salesperson's last name, their first name, the region they're in. It looks like their figures for quarters 1 through 4. Column H has some totals, and I has the average quarter. Now, the first thing I notice when I'm looking at this is I've got a couple of cells with some zeros in them. So let's go down to cell D18. This is Chica. And let's make a comment about why she has zero for quarter one. So let's say she was actually hired in April, so she wouldn't have any numbers for the first quarter. So what we're going to do is right click on that cell and we're going to insert a comment. Now the first thing you'll notice when you insert a comment is that it does have the user's name automatically. So if you don't want it there for some reason, you can go ahead and select it and you can hit delete if that's what you want to do. But those are very helpful, especially when you share files, because then you'll know who made which comment. So I'm going to go ahead and just put a blank line in here. So I'll say Chica was hired in April. Now, notice when I click away from the cell where the comment is, the comment disappears. There's a red indicator on the top right of that particular cell, and if I point my mouse there, the comment will appear. If I move away from it, the comment disappears. Let's try another one. Let's go up to G6. This is Barbara. Let's say that Barbara actually left the company in September, and that's why she doesn't have any figures for quarter four. So we'll right click, we'll insert a comment. Barbara left the company in September. Okay, and the same thing. You'll see if I move away from it, the indicator's there, but the comment has disappeared. Now let me show you where you go to work with these comments. If you go to the tab that says Review, here's the comments grouping. So a couple things I want you to notice. I could have inserted a new comment by clicking right here on this new comment button. But what I want to do right now is I want to look at all the comments that I have in this particular sheet. So I'm going to choose this option, Show All Comments, and you can see they all appear on my spreadsheet. Now you'll notice the first thing is the comments are actually covering up some of my data. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click inside of the comment, and I'm going to place my mouse around the edges. When I get that white arrow, I can actually drag and move that comment off to the side so I can see my data. And I'll do the same thing down here with this one. Perfect. And you can see when you do this, there is still an arrow that points to the cell that comment refers to. So I can always turn my comments on or off by choosing Show All Comments. Now, I want to also point out this next and previous. If you have a lot of comments you're working with, then you can have it go to the next or previous comment for you. Let's say I'm clicked in this first comment, and you can see that I have it selected. And now that I'm clicked in there, I want to go to the next comment. So I'm going to choose next, and you'll see how it took me to the next one. Now if I click next now, because I'm at the bottom of my sheet, I will get a message that asks if I'd like to go back up to the top of the sheet to continue reviewing my comments. So if I click OK, notice it took me back to the first comment. So that's pretty much how those comments work. Now let me show you how they look if you want to print them. If I go to the Page Layout tab, this Page Setup grouping, there's an arrow in the bottom right. And we had actually gone through all of these page setup options in a previous module, But let's go over to the Sheet tab. Now, right now, where it says Comments, I'm going to print them as Displayed on Sheet. And here's what that looks like. I'll just print Preview at the bottom. This is going to show the comments exactly the way they look on your sheet. Now let me go show you the other option. We'll go back to the Page Layout tab. The arrow in the bottom right of the grouping. We'll go back to the Sheet tab, and I want to choose at End of Sheet. And this time when I print preview, here's what I want you to notice. You actually have two sheets. The comments are not on Sheet 1. If I go down to the bottom and choose Next Page to put me on Sheet 2, here's where the comments actually are. They're on a separate sheet, and notice it will list the cell, the person's name that wrote the comment, and the comment itself. So you do have the ability to use those comments to help you know what's going on with the data in your workbook. So I'm going to go back to the Home tab here. And what I want to do now is we're going to talk a little bit about the Goal Seeker feature that Excel has over in the next section. So I'll see you there.